Okay, folks, we're back at camp. End of day three, right here around the fire. We got in on a really nice buck
in a very ugly place.
Bad place. About 100, 175 inch deer. We got both of us tag holders in on the buck. Kind of staged a little bit different spots in the basin, right around 125 yards. And man, we sat on that buck till
2 hours straight.
From about 5:15 till 7 o'clock at night, and that buck would not get up out of the willows. He was in a really nice bed right there, so.
Covered him all up, his whole body. All we could see was his top fork.
Just tips of the antlers in there, and never got up. We gave the old rock throws a try, and tried to slide in a little closer with poor light, and anyway, he ended up seeing us before we could see him.
He wasn't gonna budge. He was stuck in a little island in there, and probably gonna stay there until it got dark, and then just sneak his way out. And the only other avenue we had was throwing a rock. That didn't work, so I figured, okay, I'll slide in a little closer, see if he stands when he hears me. And Braxton could pound him, and jumped up, and all we had was what, neck?
Yeah.
Neck and face, and ran through that tall buck brush, and adios, till another day. So. At least we're seeing big bucks. Braxton walked into a giant today. And
nice buck. Jumped him at 45 yards. I had no idea he was even there.
Not even any time to get a shot off. So we're getting closer. Day three, we're getting closer. Yeah. So hopefully we got one more morning. We can hunt in the morning. And then Bruce the Moose gets here and got some deer. Hopefully if they're still around, that set up for him. And we can pound him a deer
on
Thursday morning.
Day four.
Well, you can see we have another beautiful sunny day. Second morning, we've been kind of hurt with rain, fog, thunder, lightning.
Hail.
Braxton got a little nervous with that lightning last night. A couple times it got pretty bright right over camp. So we didn't get out this morning. So we're taking today as a day to go to town, replenish on some foods. Old Bruce the Moose flies in tonight at 6:15. So little bro will have big bro.
Yeah. Little bro is going to bring the luck. Well, we just got to camp. Not sure what time it is. We're getting late into the night. We're going to get Bruce the Moose set up, and we're hunting bucks in the morning. Part two of this trip has begun.
Well, we just confirmed it's one of our hit list bucks from back in July. It was our number one buck. We called him Gerber, and we just got him pulled up from July. And here he is right now, live in the phone scope. He's just blew up. He's got more trash than we had seen in July. He's a great deer. He's down in some secondary living, though. He's about 1,000 yards below where we've seen him. Just working some of these shoots, so hopefully we can put him to bed. It's pretty thick, but he's a great freaking deer, great buck.
Well, we got Gerber bedded down. He's in a really tough spot, clear down here off this spine ridge. We're gonna try and play it a little patient.
see if tonight, most of the bucks work up, so we're hoping he feeds up higher. Either scoot over there tonight or get in on him in the morning, just with where he's at. We don't know that he's real killable. I'm trying to just play it smart, see what happens, so stay tuned.
Shot this morning about 112 yards. Don't know where the heck the bullet went. Thing just stared at me for 10 minutes, and of course Jeff left all the ammo about a mile behind us. So he had to sprint up a mountain, and by the time he got back, the deer was gone. And that's my story for this morning. Pretty bum, but we got a couple more bucks located tonight. We're gonna get in there and see what we can find.
Dude, congrats. Oh, hell yes. Worked our freaking ass off for that buck, man. Congrats.
I got 100 yards above him. I don't even know if I should block up. I don't even know what to do. I'm trying
to... Go get him, man.
He's so big bodied. He's probably 27 wide, one eye guard. Decent forks all the way around the front. More than 30 seconds and you go up, and I'm thinking, oh god, here we go. The wind was terrible, and then all of a sudden I looked through my alleyway I was telling you I had, and here comes his body, and I was like, oh my god. And I just gave it a whistle, and he fucking looked right up at me and whoop, boom, and he fucking hit the dirt right here.
Thank you, brother.
Oh, fucking A.
Freaking A. Oh, we dropped a stud. We dropped a stud.
God, dude.
I can't believe it.
Little recap, take you guys along step by step. I had the spotter, Shane, the man, across the canyon. Here's the first part of it. We dumped packs up here, and Shane had this great big dead tree down here. This is step one. Get to there and listen for the next instruction. Oh yeah, there's a good one. Is that the one you were talking about? So when you were saying, if you get to that, you should be able to see him. I'm thinking, dude, that is thick as crap. Like, look down there.
Oh, jeez.
And you're like, hey, he's just beyond that big log. And I'm thinking, no. Oh. Here we go. This was all on my butt. Sliding, sliding. What a find. Oh, I think I got out here. There's my dead tree. No, I'm over here. We're in his bedroom. So we got right here. Kept sneaking down on our butts. And you said down and right of the log, which you're correct, perfect. And you were wanting me to get to there and see down the same lane. That downed log. And I had just a teeny window. And Shane all of a sudden goes, he's up, he's repositioning. So I hold tight and sitting down right. Literally, there's my foot track. And Shane goes, oh, he's coming out to your left. And here's my window. And that buck come right out into that window. And I gave him one whistle, just, and he stopped and looked at me. Bang, laid the freaking hammer, dude. Right there. And see the tree if you come my way a touch? That's where he was bedded. That pine tree. Here is our Taw Team 2019 Colorado High Country Buck. It's one of three tags filled. We're into day six. And man, this is a group effort. I could have not done this without Jeff, Shane, Bruce. I mean, such a huge team effort. I couldn't be more thankful for these guys. We're all so blessed to be able to do what we love. And man, what a freaking trip. It's been a riot. Can't thank these guys enough. They are top notch. And there's really big things ahead. So I hope you guys stay following along. And what a hunt. We were just informed that Bruce and Jeff are on the ridge across, and we got a mamba bear and a cub already coming in on our kill here. This is when boys are separated from men. Not funny stuff, though.
Bad
4-point buck.
I'll take her.
First day here.
Thank you.
it's still running.
I think he hit him.
Did he?
Oh, he's getting tippy.
Is he going
down? He goes.
He's down.
Woo! That a baby! 3 for baby!
He's down, Pops! He's down!
First time I got up and I was like, I couldn't even get up. I don't know where I snuck that bullet in. I can't wait to see where it hit.
Pretty high.
I had nothing. Hunt number 2 of the grind, season of the grind, in the books. Great hanging here with all 4.
Heck yeah.
Marty back there behind the camera.
Even though his name's really Shane,
but his new nickname is Marty Stouffer on Wild America.
He's a little aboriginal boy.
Yeah, guy never stops walking. we put in the work this week. I don't think there was a spot we didn't cover up there.
No. Mentally, physically, we're tested.
It was day 6 till the first buck hit the dirt, and then 2 went down on
same
day 6, and then old panic boy over here with the 3-point shot to win the basketball game had to pull through it. 6 o'clock last night to get on the board so I didn't go home as the solo loser. So had a great time. Couldn't have written a book better than this week, how much fun I had, and share it with all the
good laughs
4 of us sure. here together. So
hunt of a lifetime. Never forget it.
So stay with us. More hunts to come for the season of the grind.